This Mass we pray for the special intentions for St. Philip and James parishioners, and also pray for the intentions of the family of Mr. Mutebi and his wife, Maria, and especially for the healing and quick recovery of their daughter, Bernadette Mutebi. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brethren, let us continue their sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Then I ask grace in the name of God, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Renew your church, we pray, O Lord, the spirit with which you endowed your Bishop St. Augustine, that filled with the same spirit we may thirst for you, the sole fount of true wisdom, and seek you, the author of heaven love, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading. If anyone is willing to walk, neither should that one eat. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We instruct you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to shun any brother who walks in a disorderly way, and not according to the tradition they received from us. For you know how one must imitate us. For we did not act in a disorderly way among you, nor did we eat food received free from anyone. On the contrary, in toil and drudgery, night and day we worked, so as not to burden any of you. Not that we do not have the right. Rather, we wanted to present ourselves as a model for you, so that you might imitate us. In fact, when we were with you, we instructed you that if anyone was unwilling to walk, neither should that one eat. May the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times and in every way. The Lord be with all of you. This greeting is in my own hand, Paul's. This is the sign in every letter. This is how I write. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways. For you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Behold, thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
love of God is truly perfected in Him. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
Alleluia.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You are like whitewashed tombs, which appear beat from the outside, but inside you are full of dead men's bones and every kind of filth. Even so, on the outside you appear righteous, but inside you are filled with hypocrisy and evil doing. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You build the tombs of the prophets and adorn the memorials of the righteous. And you say, 'If we had lived in the days of our ancestors, we would not have joined them in shedding the prophets' blood.' Thus, you bear witness against yourselves that you are children of those who murdered the prophets. Now, fill up what your ancestors measured out." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, today we celebrate the memorial of St. Augustine of Hippo. He was born in North Africa of a Christian mother, Monica, whose memorial was celebrated yesterday, and a pagan father, Patricius. His mother brought him up as a Christian, though not baptized, and by divine calling was later baptized, studied philosophy and theology, ordained a priest and later bishop of Hippo in the Roman province of North Africa. He described the spiritual journey in his famous work entitled The Confessions. St. Augustine's life teaches us that it's never too late to turn to the Lord, as confirmed by one of his quotes: "Let have I loved you, Lord." In the Gospel, our Lord Jesus continues with his strong words of denunciation to the conduct of the Pharisees and the scribes, who were among the religious leaders of his time. "Remember, our Lord, as words of tenderness and forgiveness for sinners, the fallen and the weak, because he knows the sincerity and truthfulness of their hearts." But he was unbending with the scribes and the Pharisees because he knew they were living in willful deceit. They became obsessed with the lots of legalities in their endeavor to win public approval. Today we heard how our Lord sternly confronted them, that they are like whitewashed tombs, which appear beautiful on the outside, but inside are full of dead men's bones and every kind of filth. What a strong language and determination of our Lord to lead people to conversion. Apart from trying to win attention from the public as being pious, they were insincere, pretentious, and whose outward and inward dispositions did not manifest consistency. This is an urgent call on us, brothers and sisters, to live authentic lives, accepting our lights and shadows, accepting ourselves as we are actually, and need to seek
Repentance whenever we stray from the correct teaching of God's law without mere outward pretense. The Lord knows what's deep down in our hearts. There is no need for deceit to win favors or recognition from His church. In his letter to the Thessalonians, St. Paul showed also concern about the conduct of believers in their faith and keeping the reputation of the church. He commanded withdrawal from anyone who brought stain upon the community of believers by behaving wildly or being idle. They were to follow the ways that Paul and his companions laid down in writing and by their way of life. Of course, much of the confusion and idleness for many arose over misunderstanding the gospel as to whether the day of the Lord's second coming had arrived or was so soon. That the Thessalonians even stopped working and quit their jobs, and yet they needed food every day. That's why St. Paul awakened their mind by devising no food for those who were not working. The lesson to us is that we should never fall into temptations of determining God's manifestations. We have to keep on working as though there will never be an end, and at the same time pray as if the end is so soon. Let us pray therefore for the intercession of St. Augustine for the grace to avoid all forms of idleness and pretense in the church. Confident of God's goodness, let us bring Him our needs. For the church, may she, as the bride of Christ, receive His every blessing and grace to always grow deeper in love and fidelity to Him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For civic and political leaders, may God shepherd them in their service to their communities. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who suffer, may God sustain them through His loving presence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For this worshiping community, may the Holy Spirit enkindle within us a heart to rejoice in the blessings with which we are showered each day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for the special intentions of our Christians of SPJ, and special intentions and prayers for the family of Mr. Mutevi and his wife Maria, especially for healing and quick recovery of their daughter, Bernadette Mutevi. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who have died, marked as Christ's own forever, may they enter into eternal life in paradise. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And in silence we present our special intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Gracious Father, hear our prayers and provide what we need. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. beseech your mercy, O Lord, that this sacrament of your loving kindness may be for us the sign of unity and the bond of charity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Send them also to
God. Let us give thanks to Lord our God.
It is
right and just our duty and our salvation. Always and ever to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after the festival of St. Augustine, you bid your church rejoice. So to you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in the answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we are today.
Holy, holy, holy God, Lord God of hosts,
and Lord of glory,
Hosanna in the highest, blessed is the house of the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make good therefore these gifts by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time of betrayal and entering into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." This now supposes that they took their chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for many, for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the death of the Lord until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you hear us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. And we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Timothy our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have visited throughout the ages, we may make you become heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor to yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grace us to grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, for live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold, the Lamb of God, behold you who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who go to the banquet of the Lamb. Let us pray. May partaking of Christ's table sanctify us with prayer, O Lord, that being made members of his body, we may become what we have received through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
They must end it, go in peace.
Thank you.
And have a blessed day.
Thank you.
Send my God.
Eternal God.